Turns out, me killing the albatross wasn't pleasing to the gods. And it turns out, there were people on that boat. Or not at all people. They were life and death.
Frightening. It looks like it's a matter of life and death now, Captain.
Yeah, I know, they can't get us.
I'm playing peekaboo down here.
Especially can't get me up here on the front of the boat.
Hello, sailors. I would like to play a game. All of your lives you have spent sailing around, looking for conquest and killing God's creatures. Well, now, there's going to be vengeance upon you. We will now play a game, and if you lose to me, you will die in the most gruesome of ways. So, are you ready? Live or die, make your choice. Let's begin. I got a 5.
2.
Oh, I'm winning. Damn,
it's a 1.
You drop the die. Mwahaha.
Let me roll again. 7!
What the hell? How do you get that on a 6-sided die? Are you f***ing kidding me?
I don't know, but I get the mariner. Ha!
Alright, but I still get to kill all of the seamen.
Did you smell that?
The same goes for the rest of you. You will die on the count of 3. 1, 2, die!
At least they didn't get me up here.
That event scared me good, it did. And from there on, I realized that the once shadowy sea serpent that rocked me boat was now a colorful display of lights and life in the ocean.
Swing!
The snakes were making a beautiful display of colors. Making a flurry of all different lights in the deep blue sea. I'm now motivated to find a way to get my ship home.
Enough is enough! I have had it with these motherfucking snakes on this motherfucking plane!
Now I was sailing my ship home. I woke up one frightful evening to a horrible vision. My whole ship was screwed. By the damned. But in my scurviness, I decided to play another game with me seaman. Simon says, everybody put up your left hands. Now, put up your right legs. Hey, you there. You're not playing right. Vaka, kill him. While I was having fun with me zombies that got pwned before, we realized our ship was being pushed forward by an invisible force.
You know, I'm really not an invisible force. You know, this is actually a lot of hard work. I'm sitting out here rusting my bolts off. You know, it's not like I'm using the force or anything like some Jedi. What do you think this is, a George Lucas film? I suppose I'll just get back to pushing this damn boat.
Is he done yet, Baka?
No. Penance hath he done, and penance more will do.
Why does me head hurt? Where am I? Wait, I recognize that liquor store, that corner with the prostitutes. I know where I am. I'm home! She's going under! Gotta get off! Gotta get off!
Never let go, Jack!
Climb aboard, friend! Oh well.
And that is my nautical tale of treachery, adventure, and the loss of all me seamen. Arr, I loved all me sailors, I did. Except for that one, Jimmy. He was a crusty old sea dog, he was. He could never play Simon Says the way he was supposed to. Good thing he got crushed. I'm happy for that. But I've learned. You must respect God's creatures and God's humans. Unless they can't play Simon Says. Then you crush 'em and you smite 'em with lightning and thunder and lightning. And for disliking me video, if you did, and I know some of ye did, that be's a crime. And for that crime ye must pay penance. Ye must tell me tale to all your peers. Tell all your friends to look me up on YouTube and MySpace, and wherever else my tale may appear in the murky depths of the ocean.
Swing!
Okay, welcome to the bloopers reel. This is the last night of filming, Wednesday night, February 6, 2008. It is approximately 4:30 in the afternoon, and we're already ready for our first shot of Spike. Let the games begin.
Good stuff.
Here we are, 11 o'clock, Wednesday evening. I hate my life. Spike number two, final spike. This one is the Kill a Lime flip. You ready? Let's do this. So it's 1 o'clock in the morning. We're still working on the video. Alex, don't pass out. You can go ahead. Anyways, we're all tired, and we're about halfway done with the movie, so I think the major takes me.
Racing with thoughts?
I think you see it now.
I'm just gonna turn this off too.